Question number 4 from the problem set 2. One of the roots of the quadratic equation 2x square plus kx minus 2 is equal to 0 is minus 2. Find k. We know that each and every quadratic equation has two roots, and here we have given one root, that is minus 2. Means one of the value of the variable x, that is minus 2. And we have to get the value of k. Already it is given that minus 2 is the root of the given quadratic equation. So, we will put the given value into the given quadratic equation and simply we will get the value of k. Here you need not write LHS and RHS separately. When we have to write LHS and RHS separately, if we have to decide whether the given value of the variable is the root of the given quadratic equation or not. But here it is already given that one of the root of the quadratic equation is minus 2. We have given a root and we have to find the value of k. So, directly we will write the quadratic equation. We will put minus 2 in place of x. Where there is x, there we have to put minus 2 and we will get the value of k. So, here we will write the given quadratic equation as it is, that is 2x square plus kx minus 2 is equal to 0. Since one root of the quadratic equation is minus 2, putting x is equal to minus 2. Why we are putting x is equal to minus 2? Because it is given that minus 2 is one of the root of the given quadratic equation. So, we put x is equal to minus 2. This is 2 multiplied by square of minus 2 plus k multiplied by minus 2 is minus 2 is equal to 0. 2 multiplied by square of any negative number is always positive. This is plus into minus minus 2k. It's minus 2 as it is equal to 0. 2 into 4 is 8 minus 2k minus 2 it is equal to 0. This 8 minus 2 is 6 minus 2k it is equal to 0. Now we can transfer this minus 2k to the right side, or you can simply transfer plus 6 to the right side. Minus 2k is equal to minus 6. Plus 6 becomes minus 6 minus minus plus we have k is equal to 6 upon 2, that is k is equal to 3. Therefore, value of k is 3. Now, we will solve question number 5. Question number 5 from the problem set 2. It is two roots of the quadratic equation are given. Frame the quadratic equation. We have given the two roots of the quadratic equation and we have to get the quadratic equation. So, here we have 10 and minus 10. In the first example, two roots are 10 and minus 10. Means we have alpha is equal to 10 and we have beta is equal to minus 10 for the first example. These are the roots of the given quadratic equation, required quadratic equation. We have to get the quadratic equation. So, here first we will find alpha plus beta, that is equal to 10 plus minus 10 and it is equals to 0. Now, we will get alpha into beta, that is equal to 10 multiplied by minus 10 and it is equal to minus 100 plus into minus minus 10 into 10, 100. Now, we have to get the quadratic equation, since we have to write the formula here, x square minus x into bracket alpha plus beta bracket close plus alpha into beta, that is equal to 0. Now, put the values there. This is x square minus x multiplied by alpha plus beta is 0 plus alpha into beta is minus 100, that is equals to 0. Now, x square minus x into 0 is 0. And 0 need not to write there. So, we have x square minus 0 minus 100 equal to 0. This is no need to write 0 there. So, directly you can write x square minus 100 is equal to 0. Or simply you can write x square minus 0x minus 100, that is equal to 0, is the required quadratic equation. X square minus 100 is equal to 0 is required quadratic equation, as we have given the roots of the quadratic equation and we have to get the quadratic equation. Here we have x square minus 100 equal to 0 is the required quadratic equation. Now second example, we have given alpha is equal to 1 minus 3 root 5 and beta is equal to 1 plus 3 root 5. Alpha is equal to 1 minus 3 root 5 and beta is equal to 1 plus 3 root 5. First we will get sum of the roots, that is alpha plus beta is equal to 1 minus 3 root 5 plus 1 plus 3 root 5. Here negative 3 root 5, positive 3 root 5 gets cancelled and 1 plus 1 is 2. So we get alpha plus beta is equal to 2, that is sum of the roots. Now we have to get product of the roots, that is alpha into beta is equal to. So 1 minus 3 root 5 multiplied by 1 plus 3 root 5. Now since both the brackets are in the form a plus b and a minus b, we will take the product as a square minus b square, that is square of the first term minus square of the second term. So here we will write square of the first term, that is 1 square minus square of the second term, that is 3 root 5 square of it. So 1 square is 1 minus square of the second term. See, this 3 square is 9 multiplied by root 5 square is 5. 9 5 is 45. So here we will write 45. So 3 square is 9 multiplied by root 5 square is 5. 9 into 5 is 45 and 1 minus 45 is minus 44. That is the product of the roots, minus 44. Once again check this product. We have given the roots and we have to find the product of the roots. Since we have this both the factors in the form a plus b and a minus b, we use the identity there, that is a square minus b square. A plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square, and this is a square, that is 1 square is 1 minus this is b square. The value of b square, that is 3 root 5 square, is 45. And now we have to get the quadratic equation. So we write formula here, x square minus x into bracket alpha plus alpha into beta equal to 0. Put the values there, x square minus x multiplied by alpha plus beta is 2 plus alpha into beta is minus 44, that is equals to 0. And the required quadratic equation is x square minus 2x minus 44 is equal to 0. So we can write the answer here, x square minus 2x minus 44 is equal to 0 is required quadratic equation, is required quadratic equation. And now we have last example. In this last example, 0 and 7 are the roots. So, alpha and beta, the values of alpha and beta we have given, these are 0 and 7, and we have to get the quadratic equation. Here alpha is equal to 0 for the third example and beta is equal to 7. First we will get alpha plus beta, that is 0 plus 7, which is equal to 7. Then we will get alpha into beta, that is 0 into 7, which is equal to 0. Now we have the required quadratic equation, that is x square minus x into bracket alpha plus beta plus alpha into beta equal to 0. Put the values there, x square minus x into sum of the roots is 7 plus product of the root is 0, that is equal to 0. And we have x square minus 7x plus 0 is equal to 0. Now it is not necessary to write 0 there. So we can directly write x square minus 7x is equal to 0 is the required quadratic equation. Is required quadratic equation. So this is all about the question number 5. Now we will take the sixth question from the problem set 2. Question number 6. Determine the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. We have given 3 quadratic equations and we have to determine the nature of the roots of each and every quadratic equation. So we will take first example, that is 3x square minus 5x plus 7 is equal to 0 is the given quadratic equation. And we have to decide the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. As we know that the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation is depend upon the value of b square minus 4ac. The nature of the roots of the quadratic equation is depend upon the value of b square minus 4ac. We have to find the value of b square minus 4ac first. And if we have to find the value of b square minus 4ac, the given quadratic equation is into the standard form. It is very important to have the given quadratic equation into the standard form, and if it is not, then we have to put it into the standard form. So, given equation is already into the standard form, we will find the values of a, b and c first, and then we will get the value of b square minus 4ac. So, here we will write comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have value of a, that is coefficient of square term 3. We have value of b, that is coefficient of linear term, it is minus 5. And we have value of c, that is constant term 7. Now we will find b square minus 4ac first, that is discriminant. So value of b is minus 5, so square of minus 5 minus 4 into 3 into 7. Minus 5 square is 25, minus sign remains as it is, 4 3 is 12, 12 7 is 84, it's 25 minus 84. Now subtraction, says we cannot subtract 5 from this 4, so from 14 we will subtract 5, 14 minus 5 is 9, this 3, 8 minus 3 is 5, the subtraction is 59. B square minus 4ac is equal to 59, that is negative 59. Since the bigger number is negative, the answer is negative. And we know that if b square minus 4ac, now see, we find the value of b square minus 4ac, and we know that the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation is depend upon this value. If the value of b square minus 4ac is exact 0, then the roots of the given quadratic equation are the real and equal. If the value of b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then the roots of the given quadratic equations are not the real numbers. And if delta is greater than 0, then the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and unequal. So here we have minus 59, that the value of delta is minus 59. So here we can write delta is less than 0. So, value of delta, that is b square minus 4ac, is less than 0. Since this is negative number is always less than 0. So, we will write delta is less than 0. Therefore, roots of the given quadratic equation are not the real numbers. Roots of given quadratic equation, roots of given quadratic equation are not the real numbers. Now, we have second example, that is root 3 into x square plus root 2 into x minus 2 root 3 is equal to 0. And we have to again determine the nature of this quadratic equation. So, we will write that equation here, root 3 into x square plus root 2 into x minus 2 root 3 is equal to 0. As the given quadratic equation is already into the standard form, we will get the values of a, b and c first. So here we will write comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have a is equal to root 3, we have b is equal to root 2, and we have c is equal to negative 2 root 3. And we have to find the value of b square minus 4ac first, because the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation is depend upon this value. Here we have b is equal to root 2, so here we write root 2 square minus 4 into value of a is root 3 into value of c is minus 2 root 3. This root 2 square is 2, minus into minus is plus. See, this 4 multiplied by 2, we have to take the product of the numbers outside the root to the outside, that is 4 into 2 is 8. minus into minus, out of the 3, 2 numbers are negative, so minus into minus becomes plus, 4 into 2 is 8, multiplied by root 3 into root 3, that is 3, and we have 2 plus 8 multiplied by 3, that is 24. If we first take the addition, the answer is going to become wrong. We cannot add first, we have to take multiplication first. Some students may be write this as 2 plus 8, 10, and 10 into 3, 30, that is wrong. So you have to take care about that. We have to take the multiplication first, that is 24 plus 2 is 26. And now this value of b square minus 4ac, that is value of delta, is greater than 0. 26 is greater than 0. So here we can write delta is greater than 0. Delta is greater than 0 since the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and unequal. Therefore, roots of the given quadratic equation, roots of given quadratic equation are real and unequal. And last example, that is example number third, we have given a quadratic equation, that is m square minus 2m plus 1 is equal to 0, and we have to determine the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. See the equation, that is m square minus 2m plus 1 is equal to 0, that is the given quadratic equation. M square minus 2m plus 1 is equal to 0, that is the given quadratic equation, and we have to determine the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation, and again the given quadratic equation is into the standard form, so directly we have to get the values of a, b, and c comparing with a x square plus b x plus c is equal to 0, or we can write a m square plus bm plus c is equal to 0. Value of a is 1, value of b is minus 2, and value of c is 1. Now we have to get the value of b square minus 4ac since we have to determine the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. So we write b square minus 4ac is equal to value of b is minus 2, square of it minus 4 multiplied by value of a is 1 multiplied by value of c is 1. Square of any negative number is always positive since square of minus 2 is 4. This is minus sign, as it is 4 into 1 into 1, that is 4, and 4 minus 4 is 0. And since the value of b square minus 4ac, that is delta, is 0, we have delta is equals to 0. And we know that if delta is equal to 0, then the roots of the given quadratic equation are real and equal. So here we will write, therefore, roots of the given quadratic equation, roots of given quadratic equation are real and equal. This is all about the question number 6. We will study, we will solve question number 7.